Hey everyone, with extremely high pressures, an almost complete lack of light, and very little food or nutrition available to eat, the deepest parts of the world's oceans seem virtually uninhabitable. But there are plenty of species, though, that have developed the physiology and behaviors needed to live their entire lives down there, and in some cases, they're some of the strangest creatures to have ever been discovered. Join me for today's video. We're going to plunge into the murky depths and look through the top 15 most unusual deep sea animals. Let's begin. Number 15, the fangtooth. As some of the deepest living known fish of all, the two species of fangtooth, the common fangtooth and the shorthorn fangtooth, have been found in the oceans across the planet at depths of up to 16,000 feet, or about 5,000 meters. Their name in English refers to the huge fang-like teeth that protrude from the fronts of their mouths that help them to puncture the skin of their prey. But while they may look frightening, they wouldn't pose any threat to humans because they only grow to a length of around 6.3 inches, or about 16 centimeters. In comparison to their body size, fangtooths have the largest teeth of all fish. And because they don't fully sit in their mouths, they develop these specialized grooves in the jaws where the teeth sit when they aren't in use. The benefit of having these fangs is not only can they spear their targets, but they're also able to hunt prey that's much larger than themselves, which is a real advantage when living in an environment where they could go for weeks without encountering another living organism, and they need to take every opportunity to eat that presents itself. Another unusual thing about this one is that unlike other species that live at these depths, it's possible to keep them alive in aquariums for extended periods of time, showing just how adaptable they truly are in changing surroundings. Number 14, Dumbo Octopus. With a name that covers 17 known species and potentially many more, Dumbo octopuses are a type of deep sea octopus that lives in the pelagic zones of oceans worldwide. And because they live in the open water, they've developed these ear-like fins above their eyes that they use to swim or glide in the current. They're found at depths between 3,200 and 23,000 feet, or about 1,000 to 7,000 meters. They're the deepest living octopuses that we know of, and are usually seen moving along the seafloor in search of worms and crustaceans to feed on. They're also strange for octopuses in that they'll continuously spawn with eggs in various stages of the cycle, and once ready to lay, they will place them in a naturally formed tough casing on deep sea corals, and they won't stay around to guard or incubate them. Due to their habitat and how rare it is for submersibles to see them in the wild, very little is actually known about their life cycles and how they hunt or escape predators. They don't, for example, have ink sacs or the ability to change color like most other octopuses, and so few specimens have ever been available for study that it's hard to make any definitive conclusions on this one. Number 13, pelican eel. The pelican eel, which is sometimes referred to as the gulper eel, is a species of eel that typically lives at depths between 1,600 and 9,800 feet, or between 500 and 3,000 meters. Despite being present in all the oceans of the world, the extreme environment that they live in means very little is really understood about them, and virtually everything has been learned by studying specimens that have been caught in fishing nets. What we do know is that they grow to a length of about 2.5 feet, or 3/4 of a meter, and their mouths are much larger than the rest of their bodies. Their jaws are loosely hinged, which mean they can open extremely wide to swallow prey that's much larger than the eel itself, and their lower jaws are so big they represent about a quarter of the eel's length, and look somewhat like that of a pelican. Lacking the fins, swim bladders, and scales of other eels, they have highly developed tails that have an unusual organ at the tip that not only has a series of tentacles on it, but can also emit light to attract prey towards the eel. Rather than being a passive animal, though, analysis of the stomach contents of several specimens suggests that they are active hunters, whipping their tails back and forth to propel themselves through the water to chase down their next target. Number 12, dragonfish. Typically growing to around 10 inches or 26 centimeters long, dragonfish are a group of ray-finned fish that live in deep waters all over the world. Despite being relatively small, they're considered to be apex predators in their ecosystems, and it's because every feature of their bodies have been designed to hunt. Their mouths, for example, have huge jaws that are lined with needle-sharp teeth and are able to open up to 100 degrees wide, which allows them to devour their prey that's as much as 50% larger than themselves. Living in such a dark environment, they, like other deep-sea creatures, use bioluminescence to help them track down their next meal. They have an appendage known as a barbel that hangs from their chins, and at the tip of this is a light-producing photophore. With further luminous organs along the sides of their bodies, they're able to produce shades of blue and green, which travel the furthest through water and can create flashing displays to attract prey, and they also use it to communicate with potential mates. One further clever adaptation is that their stomachs are surrounded by jet black walls, and this is to protect them from other predators in the ocean. Most animals that they eat tend to also have bioluminescent abilities, and if they were to produce light while being digested, it could give away their location. So by blotting this out, the dragonfish can digest in peace. Number 11. Sea Angel. Sea angels are a wide variety of different species of deep sea slugs that can be found in almost every ocean on Earth. They are free swimming, so instead of having a foot that's designed to hold onto something, they're what they use to propel themselves through the water, and with almost entirely translucent bodies, it soon becomes clear why they have this name. They are gelatinous to the touch and grow to a maximum length of around 2 inches or 5 centimeters. Most have a specific prey that they target, such as sea butterflies, and are able to swim much faster than other similar-sized creatures, with a top speed of around a fifth of a mile per hour, or about 10 centimeters per second. This, of course, is helpful in evading predators as much as it is for capturing prey, but some sea angels have another defensive ability, too. They produce a substance called pteranone, which has only ever been found in these animals, and for some reason prevents natural predators from eating them. It's also common to see large swarms of sea angels, in some cases as many as 300 of them per 35 cubic feet of water, or about 1 cubic meter, which allows them to have a much better chance of fending off any attack, as well as giving them the ability to work together to take down prey that's much larger than any individual. Number 10. Big Red Jellyfish. First discovered by a remotely operated underwater vehicle in 2003, the Tiburonia granrojo, which means the big red jellyfish, is one of the largest and strangest species of sea jelly that we know of. Since only about 23 specimens have been seen, with only one being retrieved for study, we still have a lot to learn about them, but what we already do know shows just how weird a place the deep ocean can be. Living at depths of around 2,000 to 5,000 feet, or about 600 to 1,500 meters, they've been found across the Pacific Ocean, such as in the Gulf of California, Monterey Bay, and the waters surrounding Hawaii, and off the coast of Japan. Believed to exhibit deep-sea gigantism, they're able to grow to around 30 inches or 76 centimeters in diameter, and are visibly different from other jellyfish species. Instead of having tentacles dangling from a bell, for example, they have between 4 and 7 fleshy oral arms, and scientists aren't yet sure how these are used for hunting. Without being able to use the technique adopted by most other jellies, it's thought that these arms grab onto fish that swim too close and slowly push them up towards the jelly's mouth. There's one thing for certain, though, and that's that we're lucky they only live at depths far beyond where we can swim, because you'd be in for a fright if you found yourself amongst a swarm of these animals. Number 9. Giant Larvacean. The deep oceans are home to some truly peculiar animals, and the giant larvacean is surely up there as one of the most bizarre. It's a type of tunicate, which is an aquatic invertebrate organism that's in the same category as plankton. But these ones live in the deepest part of the open ocean's water column. Despite their name, they are only quite small, typically growing to around the size of your pinky finger, and look similar to a tadpole. They produce a house of cellulose that surrounds the main part of their body as a protective layer, and they'll then produce a separate structure of filters that they'll pass water through with their tails, and then feed on whatever's caught. They are a crucial part of the marine ecosystem because of the way they capture small particulates and then themselves become a tasty morsel of food for larger animals. But they've also been seen in recent years to be tackling one of the greatest threats in the world's waters. Larvaceans are able to capture and digest plastic particles, and there are now studies underway to look at the feasibility of releasing large swarms of them onto the Great Pacific Garbage Patch in an attempt to dispose of all the plastic in an environmentally friendly way. Number 8. Blobfish. Alright, possibly the strangest looking ocean creature that we know of is the Psychrolutus microporus, that's more commonly known as the blobfish, and it's a deep sea species that lives at depths between 3,000 and 19,000 feet, or between 900 and 6,000 meters in the waters around Australia and New Zealand. The first specimen was captured in 1983, and scientists couldn't believe what they were looking at. But since further individuals have been found, it's become clear that not all is exactly as it seems. They are well known for their globular appearance, seeming almost like a human face has been made from soggy gelatinous substances. They weigh around 4 pounds, they're white in color, and have an extremely wide mouth. But this isn't what the fish normally looks like. Because they live at such depths, they live in an environment where they're exposed to extreme pressure. Animals in this situation don't often have skeletal structures, so instead rely on the pressure of the water to hold their bodies together. When they're alive, they look recognizably like any other type of fish, and certainly nowhere near as strange as the captured specimens have. The reason for this difference is that when they're caught at depth and brought to the surface too quickly, the fast drop in pressure causes the cells in their tissue to rupture and lose their cohesiveness. The result is this strange mound of flesh that we now know as a blobfish, something that you'll unfortunately never have to worry about encountering one when you're swimming in the water. Number 7. Coffin fish. The coffin fish, it's one of the 17 species of sea toad that are found across the world, but because of the deep environment they live in, they've only been known of since 1997. Growing to be around 9 inches or 25 centimeters long, they're mainly found in the Pacific, but they've also been found in the Atlantic Ocean at depths of up to 8,000 feet or 2,400 meters. In many ways, they are the deep water equivalent of a puffer fish. Normally, they are ball-like with loose, flabby skin over their bodies, but when they feel in danger, they'll use their gills to fill their bodies with water and increase their size by up to 30%. This causes a series of spine-like scales to become rigid and firmly stick outwards, which give a nasty surprise to anything trying to bite into them. Cleverly, they also have adaptations that help them hunt food too, in particular an ilium on their snout that is either stored by being lowered into a groove on their heads or, when they're hungry, extended forward to act as a lure to attract small creatures like crustaceans or fish. Number 6. Glass octopus. Found at depths in the tropic and subtropic oceanic regions worldwide, the glass octopus is a peculiar species that, as the name would suggest, is almost entirely transparent, with a mantle that grows up to 4.3 inches or about 11 centimeters in length, and tentacles that are up to 13 inches or 34 centimeters long. 6 of their arms are the same length, while the final pair are slightly shorter. They have small suckers with wide gaps between each one, and have cylindrical, elongated eyes that severely restrict their field of vision horizontally. Rather than being an unfortunate adaptation, there's actually a good reason for this, along with their transparency, and it all has to do with avoiding predators. Glass octopuses aren't able to swim particularly fast, so completely rely on being invisible to everything else. Light from above simply passes through them, so they're almost indistinguishable from everything surrounding them, and the only colorful parts of them, their eyes, have a reduced silhouette because of their shape. Another unusual thing about them is that as they age, their diet and habitat drastically changes. When they're young, they have tough beaks and live in deep water, with the ability to tear into the toughened scales of fish that live in that environment. The beaks are eventually shed, though, and replaced by less developed ones, and this sees the octopus move to shallower waters where they can feed on softer-bodied prey. Number 5. Sea pig. Scotoplanes, which are more commonly known as sea pigs, are a type of sea cucumber that live in the depths of the ocean, but they look like they'd be more at home on an alien world. They're typically found on the seafloor in the Atlantic, Pacific, and Indian Oceans, at depths of up to 16,000 feet or about 5,000 meters. Although closely related species have also been found in the Antarctic and other regions that are in deep places. What look like limbs are in fact tube feet, and these are connected to the water vascular system throughout their bodies that allow them to keep a rigid structure. In the environment that they live, there aren't as many predators as their shallower water cousins face, so these sea cucumbers are very different from the ones that are more commonly seen. They have antennae on their head, which are technically feet, but are used to search around in pitch-black surroundings where they sift through the mud in search of organic material. It's rare to see one of these on their own, as they live in colonies of potentially hundreds of individuals, and when a large food source falls to the bottom, such as the carcass of a dead whale, let's say, thousands can be attracted in to feast. Number 4. Giant siphonophore. If you were asked what the longest animal in the world is, you'd probably choose the blue whale or some other huge creature. The surprising answer, though, is the giant siphonophore, a species that was only officially identified in 2020. These marine predators are similar to jellyfish in that they float in the ocean with a series of tentacles hanging from them. When a fish swims into the tentacles, they're injected with venom, and the siphonophore slowly guides the body up towards its main body so it can begin digesting those nutrients. In fact, siphonophores are made up of a number of different clones of themselves that all work together, and the longest one to have ever been studied was simply huge, with a length of over 150 feet or 46 meters. This makes it more than twice the length of a blue whale and 3 times the length of a humpback. The recent research that found this monster was conducted in a protected area called the Gascoyne Coast bioregion in Western Australia, and this particular discovery was made purely by chance as the submersible was returning to the surface. It's highly likely, therefore, that there are ones far bigger still, and it's hoped a future research trip may be able to find one. Number 3. Goblin Shark. Often said to be living fossils because they can be traced back to fish that were alive 125 million years ago, goblin sharks are some of the strangest aquatic animals that have ever been discovered. Growing to a maximum length of around 20 feet, or about 6 meters, they live at depths of more than 330 feet, or 100 meters, and are believed to venture as deep as 4,200 feet, or 1.3 kilometers, for brief periods of time. Present in all oceans of the world, they get their name from their freakish heads, which have a long, flat snout along with a mouth that's full of needle-like teeth. And when they're feeding, their jaws extend unusually far in front of their resting position. Because of where they live, very little is actually known about their behavior, but their weak muscles, small fins, and poorly calcified skeleton suggest they're slow and fairly inactive animals. They are therefore most likely to be ambush predators, which is something made easier by their oily livers that help them to be naturally buoyant. They can use this to drift towards their potential prey without any movement, which means they avoid detection. And once they're on top of their victim, they can snap into action. Number 2. Barrel Eye. Very little light manages to penetrate to the depths of the ocean, so animals that live there have to adapt to this way of life. While some may use bioluminescence to find their way around, there's a group of fish that have gone in a completely different direction. There are 21 known species of barrel eye, which are present in oceans around the world, and while their body shapes may differ substantially, they each use the same unique method of seeing their surroundings, which also makes them one of the most unusual-looking fish of all. This is because they have eyes that are barrel-shaped and tubular and actually look upwards. This allows them to discern shadows against the shimmering light above, and means they can either plan an attack on potential prey or plan an escape from a predator. It's not all that unusual about their eyes, though, because the front parts of their heads are completely transparent. This is because they're actually able to control the movement of the eyes so they can rotate down and instead look directly ahead. This whole design is to maximize the amount of light that enters the head, and therefore the eyes. And with a much higher level of sensitivity than in almost any other animal, barrel eyes are able to see in a way no other creature at depth can. Number 1. Chimera. Chimera, which are often called ghost sharks, are a type of fish that are most closely related to sharks and rays, although they diverged from them in the evolutionary chain around 400 million years ago. They were once a huge biological group that were present in all the oceans at all depths around the world, but this has now changed. And while they're still in the oceans apart from the Arctic and Antarctic ones, they're usually found at depths between 600 and 8500 feet, or about 200 to 2600 meters. Developing long, soft bodies with large heads and just a single gill opening, chimera tend to grow to a maximum length of 4.9 feet, or 1.5 meters, and share a few similar features to modern-day sharks. Their skeletons are, for example, made of cartilage, and they can use electroreception to find prey and lay similar leathery eggs. Some species do, however, also have venomous spines like the ones some rays have, and instead of having replaceable sharp teeth, they have three rows of grinding plates. There's no doubt that when seen at depth, chimera look like ancient creatures, and because of their habitat, many species remain a mystery to science. There are currently 50 known species of chimera that are still alive, but some believe there could be many more, and possibly some that grow much, much larger. I'll see you next time. Watch our Animals playlist for more top 15 videos about animals. Sit back, relax, and binge watch all of our best animal-related videos.